Yes. Oh, yes. We just thank you. Thank you for your spirit. Oh, fill us. Your spirit. Yes.
Baptizing, making more disciples than John.
though Jesus himself did not baptize them, his disciples did. So he left Judea and returned to Galilee. Coming back to the word of when he's in with John, because it seemed like when Jesus was here doing his work, it always was someone there judging who was the better person or the better man. And John knew within himself that he knew he was just there to prepare the way for God. And even though the people came to him and was talking to him, but like he was, they'll tell you back in the olden days that people were saying things to discourage what you was doing. But if you're not steadfastly scraping, thirsty for what God given you in your heart and your desire for him, they will take you off the path. It'll make you pour the water out. And then you got to go back and get the water again, and you got to come to that place that God have us to be. And we're going to go farther. Hallelujah. He had to go through Samaria on the way. Eventually, he came to the Samaritan village of Sychar, near the field that Jacob had gave to his sons, Joseph. Jacob's well was there, and Jesus, tired from a long walk, sat wearily beside the well. About noontime, soon a Samaritan woman came to draw water, and Jesus said to her, "Please give me a drink."
Hallelujah.
Jesus. We sit and we dwell in the God. He said, "Please give me a drink." He was, I won't say he was begging, but he was from that walk, from that back in the Bible day, it was like we got a car today. I mean, they walked a long way from town to town. A long walk. And we got some of us today don't want to get on a bicycle.
Over
around the corner, or they think you're too proud to even walk. And we know that in the back in them days, Lord God, they true servant to do his work, even they had to walk to get there. They didn't have on the best shoe, they had on sandals, and they had on the clothes that could cover them when they could go walk in the sun, but I don't think they had a head garment. But anyway, God, they was intended to do God's work. But God, he came here for a reason, to show men that what God gave us to do, we can do it. Trials and tribulations gonna come. But we got to stay the path, stay the course. Every snare gonna come for us to not to want to do it. Somebody gonna come and try to pick you off. You got to keep going. Even in the point that you say you can't speak that well, I'm not capable of doing this. But God said, go.
That's right.
And do. That's right. What I have put in your mouth, what I have put in your belly to speak out.
Right.
They have to hear what you have to say. And do God, do my work. It ain't of you, but it's God working through you.
Amen.
But you know, sometimes some people take the credit for what they do. And God be blessing them, and then they turn around. After a while, they'll say, "I did this." Now, when they go start saying "I," you know it's going to be a problem.
Right.
It's going to be a big problem in what they are doing, and they are not truly doing God's work. But God will use anybody. Really, he can use somebody to come up and say a word to you to get you back on the right track. That's how just our Father is to us. We're going to go a little further in the scripture. He was alone at the time because his disciple had gone into the village to buy some food. The woman was surprised, for Jews refused to have anything to do with Samaria. In that scripture alone, you knowing they had discord in against each other. Something like today, you got our race, other race, but then some people got they grew up with that angerness in their heart. Their parents taught them how to hate people. And when you come to know this person of a different color, you find out they are not like that.
Right.
And you like, why they got to hate so much? What caused that?
Yeah.
You be trying to figure out it's what the parents installed in them when they was younger, and that's all they knew.
Right.
To hate somebody, just hating somebody, just to hate them because their parents had that hurt, or maybe somebody did something to them that they didn't like, and that hate came, and then so now they gonna take that hate and let it establish through the generation.
Uh-huh.
And letting it go through the generation to carry it, because it'll go a long way if they keep holding on, come tied into it, they'll keep going. It'll keep going and tear up everything that's in its path until one, just one, stop and say, no, I'm not going to deal with this anymore.
That's right.
I am going to handle this. It's like a generation curse of a father being an alcoholic, drug addict, being on the streets, doing what he do, until
right.
father,
right.
or even the mother, both parties, come to the realization and say, I am going to stop this.
That's right.
Stop doing it. Meaning thirsting for God to want to change and want to do right and
that's
want
right.
to live right,
right.
No matter what the cause of the situation. Because we know that our generation, when we say generation curse, a lot of people say, well, no, generation curse ain't real.
Uh-uh.
But when you look at it and you sit back and everything begun to unfold, and you sit back and look,
right.
and you say, well, look, maybe it didn't hit my children, but it hit my sister children, my brother children. It didn't hit them, and they went out on the court. They went out and they doing what our ancestors had done in the past. And yet do our heart go out for them and want them to come into the knowledge of God. They'll get mad with us and won't up to say it and call you all names holy than thou. And all you could do is just pray for them.
That's right,
and say, God will make a way out of no way. No matter what. Because you know you yearn for them to be saved, but you know just like God with us. God don't put no pressure on us. He don't put it on us. He let us go do what we want to do. How we want to do it. He don't say nothing. He don't say nothing. But then it comes that time that some people end up getting sick with a disease or something, laid up in the hospital, or may come into a mere accident for God to slow you down, for him now he got you there, now he can talk to you. You still, you can't move, you can't get up and go, you can't get up and just take off and go anywhere. But God permit for us to do what he wants. And keeping the course doing he have at what he want us to do. And we have to look up and say, you know what? God, I am thirsty for you.
Yes.
I thirst and I long for you, Lord.
Yes.
I long to do your will no matter what.
Yes. Oh, yes, God.
I'm so thirsty. thirsty right now, Jesus. Lord. All I need,
Jesus,
is this a teardrop. A teardrop of your water.
Yes, hallelujah.
Give it unto me, Lord. That I may take the water, Lord. Not just to drink it, Lord, and swallow it, but to drink it and truly use it. No matter my friends, people that I know, and don't be ashamed to do His work, no matter what. No shame in our gain. That's the meaning for God. Because you went out and partied with Him, why should you be ashamed to go back and witness to Him? In God.
Wow.
I used to say, I ain't worthy. I can't speak well. God said, so on. You make the first step, I think.
Lord God.
You just take the step, and I'll be there for you.
That's it.
No, I ain't sorry for crying. I thank God for this, this joy, the tears coming down. Refreshing. Bubbling up in my soul.
Hallelujah.
Then it's more than ready with you to be able to take it. Take it in. Take in of His Spirit.
Hallelujah.
God, just thank
you.
Keep going for and she said to Jesus, you are a Jew. I am a Samaritan woman. Why are you speaking? Why are you asking me for a drink? Jesus replied, if you only knew the gift God has for you. And who are you speaking to? You would have, you ask me, and I would give you living water.
Hallelujah! Living water.
Imagine back in the time where some people actually started there and spoke to us, was talking to them. Actually talking to them, just like I'm looking at y'all. They talking to Him. And yet they didn't know. And then He, just like when He replied and told her, you knew who you were speaking to. You would ask me and I will give you living water.
Glory, glory, glory.
All we had to do was just ask God. And He give it. We thirst for Him. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. We're drinking that water. Drinking that water. He thirsts for the water of Jesus. His soul, His countenance, His every being. Even the forgiveness over somebody make you mad that you can hold down your anger and still be humble.
Jesus.
Just like they didn't even say anything to you.
Hallelujah. Thank you, God.
And you don't let them get and disturb your spirit. But when you say to them, God bless you. Some of them get mad and call you every word but the child of God. But God bless you.
Amen. That's it.
And God is that's just. Because he walked on this earth. He showed us that we can take the course just like he did. Go through it.
Amen.
Live through it.
Right.
Abide by it.
Yes.
No matter what. Because things come up in our life and we say, well, we got to have this. We're thirsting for stuff that we shouldn't have. But I wouldn't say a job, because everybody need a job or need a work. But some people thirst for too much for the, gain, and they get the money and get the gain of money, and then they forget about God. They forget, they forget about, they got on their praise and they ask the saints to pray for them and say, well, I need a job. And when God give them that job, hear me now, when he give them that job, then they might do the back up and say, well, you know what? Don't say, ah, they forget. Then one of the members might call and say, where you been at? I ain't seen you in a while. I say, well, I've been working.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, now, you've been working. But God, you asked the saints to pray for you to give you this job. Now you don't want to serve God. So now they're taking the money, throwing the money away, squandering the money, doing what they want to do with it, but they are not thinking about coming back to the service of God, to serve God. Because God give you something, he give it to you to give it back to him, the blessing. But a lot of people think that, oh, the pastor, the preacher money. They want the money for themselves so they can go live it up and then go do what they gotta do. Here I am to tell you now, I'm not one of them preachers or however you want to say elder that doing the work for a gain. So God gave me ability to work, even in the church, even though I still will work with the service and go by what I need for myself. Not using, not seeking first, look for no money to get paid, just doing the will of God. That's how it should be. Doing the will of God. Some people got a price on what God gave them. He gave them the gift to be able to speak to the people and bring the people. Then they have to turn around and this is me. Now they forgot that all the time they was in 5 or 6 years in Bible study, learning the word, doing what they got to do. Right and dividing the word, doing it. Now they're going to take the word and mix the word up. Take it up. They're going to take it and mix the word up and put it for their game. Well, I built this. Just I built this. Nobody can take this from me. Well, God built this through you. He built it for you to give it and help to other people. Not build it for yourself. Because you see people start to get selfish and doing stuff that they don't supposed to do, and they don't care. I mean, doing it just like it's just a fad.
Right.
Next minute, they walking down, coming down. Now they out of the pulpit. They doing their thing in the street. They sitting down. Now you might see him somewhere in a position that he don't supposed to be. And you like, I know him. And you walk up to him and say something. No, you got the wrong person. You got the wrong person.
Wow.
No, but I seen you over so-and-so Sally Sue house. You was going through the your car was parked right there, but you were going around the back way.
Oh,
how special is that, you?
But some people think it's like they people see you. You sit down in the house, study the word, and thank God. What you were doing over there? Ain't nobody per se coming to you, but God speaking through the inside.
Right.
You know,
right.
You should be over there.
That's right.
But God, I just smiled. Oh God, I didn't make you to do this. I didn't feel you this way to come and deceive the people. You deceiving the people because you living a ragged life. And now you go there and people looking at you now because you got people that's weak.
That's right.
And what you do is what they see it, and then they black, it's all right for them. Because I can say this for myself, I was young. You know how you got the deaconess, deacon corn, preacher. I was young, but I always was curious. Hearing the deacon saying, getting up, he's singing a hymn, saying the word. But I just kept looking at them going out that door. They were going to preach with them. They were going out that side door. I'm like, we ain't going on that. But I was just going to say, no, we ain't going. But I went out and said, anyway. It is. But you smoking a cigarette, church going on. I'm looking. I didn't say nothing to him because I was, I figured. See, I can't even say nothing, but God saved in my spirit. We shouldn't have nothing. I mean, not a cigarette, takes a drink. Some people say it's all right to take a little drink every now and then. But that's all right because some people got problems with drinking. Some people can't take no drinking. So they got that spirit of won't play, they can't stop. Some people could take a sip of wine and they take that sip of wine and have a whole bottle there. Don't mess with it. But some people got that spirit that they want. They got to keep taking it. They got to keep taking it until they feel it. But God, He put us here to have a way of escape, to do His will, and to serve Him and come to Him. Because we know for ourselves that what we do, but God, He made us to accept it and okay, now I'm serving God, now I got to let this go. But sometimes a lot of people don't get delivered right away.
Amen.
But I can say I for one didn't get delivered right away. I came to church and felt happy and everything and time. Went back at the door. I'm saying this because this was me.
Right.
I go out, time church over, go back outside, go drinking, and went there to a farm, smoking cigarettes too much. But I asked God to take it from me, and that we did. Cigarette taste, the drug taste, the alcohol taste. Not saying it won't come back. Not saying it won't come back, because it will come back. Because the devil, when he loose you,
you gotta be ready.
You gotta be ready. It's like I'm standing here, he's looking, coming up, ooh, yeah, he's coming. If the first one comes, the next one comes, he's coming okay. He got himself together, so I'm going by him. I'm going to make my route. See, who else can I deceive or see how they standing. And when come, he stay. Oh, I got him. I ain't gonna follow him. I'm gonna keep going. But truth be told, that the way we live when we come to church on a Sunday, from Sunday afternoon, from Monday to next Sunday, we should be happy and glorious to God.
Amen.
Because we know trial and tribulation gonna come. It only come to make us strong, because sometimes you want to give up, or sometimes you work it and you might lose your job, and you be like, why, God, why me? Why not you?
That's right. My God.
It's a test. It's a test for us to go through and to produce what he given into us. And we knowing, because you knowing you get in a fight and you find you a corner, don't care how many people coming towards you. There ain't no, everybody they can't get to you. You gonna fight up out of that corner. But when you be free running around, they can come get you from every side to side. Bomb rush you. That's the way sin do. And then it's in our intellect and our mind. But sometimes some people sit down and plan this thing. Go on, one more time. Ooh. What did God say? Tell your business. When you preach it, tell your business so you already deliver it, so somebody else can get delivered. Person told me one time, I'm going to show you how to cheat. And you won't show me how to cheat. No, I didn't know how to cheat. I'm going to show you some stuff that I know. Wow. This ain't the same sex to me. It's a different sex. Oh. I'm like, wow. What? Oh, wow. I'm like, how you going to show me something? Then, when she said, I looked at number, what you talking about? Then I say, no, I don't think I want to know what your course is. I don't think I want to get hooked up with that. I said, come on. I got to go over here. No, I ain't want to deal with what you dealing with. I'm not going to let you put your spirit of evilness on me. No, I can't do that. But he'll walk you through stuff in your life to make you the soldier that you should be.
Amen.
Give you authority. Even though you're down on yourself, I used to be down on myself, but I ain't nobody. I ain't worthy to do this. I ain't worthy to do that. Always down on myself. And that's the spirit of witness, being down. You think nobody don't love you. Think nobody don't care for you. But then you got to know. The Father, Jesus Christ, love us the most.
That's right.
Because he put us here.
Hallelujah.
Because he's going to come a time that you're going to be by yourself.
That's right.
And nobody around.
That's right.
And remember times coming up in the country, I one time almost went to sleep. I woke up on nobody. Wait. I'm like, ain't nobody now. I walked to the back, the front of the house. Like you see the sun with the sun going down. I mean, big ball, the sun wrecked it like it's wrecked there. I'm like, oh Lord, everybody gone. I'm like, oh, I know I ain't right. Because God, even in a young age, you know within yourself that you ain't right. You ain't living right, you know.
Yes.
It's a quick check. It ain't no, I got to get it. It's right there.
Right.
Right now, instantly. 1 minute. It's an instantly check within your spirit. Knowing that you ain't living right. And you tuck it and hide and slide. Come through the window, fall out the window. But God still see it all. He see it all. And what can you do?
Amen.
What can you do only to give up and just say, well, you know what? What am I thirsting for?
Right.
I should be thirsting for God's spirit.
That's right.
To walk like him.
Yes.
To talk like him.
Yes,
God. To even give up my members to him.
That's right.
Not want to be like nobody else. Because, you know, people that have stuff,
amen.
You don't know how they get it. They, Some people truthfully go out there and work. Some people don't. Some people, it's given to them. This is like, they family got it. They got it like that. It's a generation of things that they give their children and they know how to do with money. And it's inherited. And they get the inheritance and they go, but then sometimes when they do, this one gets this inheritance. Now he living all that life. Now he feeling money he got, but he don't know they got money somewhere else, put up somebody else. Now you burn your money up, now this is what you gonna spend. Can't get no more. And some people, that's how some people do. That's how some people do their life right now. They, once they get money, they go buck wild. They go wild and, well, I can do this. I deserve this. I deserve my time. If that time you have, you better give it to God and give your worth what He's giving you.
That's right.
Some people have an excuse. Oh, my mama, my dad didn't do nothing for me. He already did it because you were here on the earth. Because He given us the chance to come on to do His work and come up as our mom asked. Because since it's like this, I'm a big fan of animal planning. Looking at the word God give a human knowledge, wisdom, and understanding. But but some people don't realize. Some people don't realize about it. Then you go to understanding what God have for us to do in an animal. They can't talk, but they teach their young how to go and survive.
Right.
Teach them at a young age. And when they start walking, they begin to teach them. They teach them how to go follow them. Teach them how to hunt. Teach them how to go and to survive. Where they go get them. They nourish them from when they do. Then after a while, when they get a certain age, just like the eagle, that chicken get a certain age. And you can't fly, boy, you finna get out of here. Push them on out. If he don't soar, too bad for him, because he's something down there waiting for him. Something waiting for him. He better get halfway down there and say, he better come up. He better come up and do what God permitted for him to do. Because being thirsty, being thirsty and being, what are you thirsty for? We could be thirsty for the things of this world, soul for things. It ain't bad being thirsty for your wife or your husband, but if it's in the wrong way, it's a bad thirst because you are not serving God. You're not serving God, and they're not serving God. But both of y'all thirsty and don't know where to go get the water from. Don't know where the well is to go get the living water.
Yes.
Living into what God has for us to do. But He said, ooh, that thirst. Let them come and drink. Let them come drink of this water that they won't thirst no more. And my Father is gracious and merciful to us. No matter what. But we know that God is all forgiving. He forgive some things that we probably be hard to forgive some people.
Come on.
And we even like, God, they did this to me. Well, how can I forgive them? I gave them some money. My friend, I gave them some money. I know a little bit of money. Say they were going to give it back at a certain time. And they didn't give the money back. Now, this is bringing bitterness to this person. Towards you and the person owe you the money. They mad at you, but they they got you, they didn't get your money, say they did. Now here we're down here, the table turn around. Then you are, you being calm, then all of a sudden something happened and you see them spend the money and you know they got your money. And you say, go down like this. And God said,
amen. Amen.
First let go come, you trying to ignore them. You ain't being that yet, but you walk in your head. What you gonna do? Next one come, let it go. Third one come, let it go. Now you gotta let it go and truly let it go. Because every time you come back and you don't let it go, it gonna bring up a discord in. Maybe in your family, somewhere else that you around and you supposed to be pastor or bishop or evangelist. Whatever the calling God give you. And they seeing you act the way you want that person to act. They don't supposed to be acting like that. But some people really, we have some saints that really, really cut up. I mean, cut up better than people pro se that ain't saved. I'm saying this because I seen this with my own eyes. And they're like, I don't want to be saved. I ain't want to be saved if they acting like them. But God said, no, I'm not saving you because you don't want to act like that. I'm saving you for you.
Amen.
I'm saving you for you. Even you down in yourself and you want to give up, you want to commit suicide, and you want to say, no, God, I don't know what to do, but you got to give up the ghost. Let God do it. No matter the situation or even the circumstance. You got to let do and thirst for him and him alone. And continue to thirst for him. We're going to go a little farther in the chapter. We're at the 13th verse, right? Okay. Jesus replied and said, anyone who thirsts of this water will soon become thirsty again. Will be soon come thirsty again. But those who drink the water that I will give never thirst again. Come in as a freshening, bubbling spring within them, giving them eternal life. The lady said, please, sir. The woman said, give me of this water that I'll never thirst again. And I won't have to come here to get water. That means that she asked him for what God was giving her. What he giving out, she asked him for. So she want what he have for her to give to her, and she accepted it wholeheartedly. Here to say that when we thirst for God's mercy, grace, His love, His kindness,
amen.
We thirst to have what He wants. But you got some people, they don't thirst for it, but they go and they learn the word and use the word against people, saints. It makes some people intimidated because they know the word so good. You can say a scripture. They can call the scripture out just like this. Right on top of their head. You think they full of the Holy Ghost. Ain't full of nothing but the devil. Because you willing to teach them, and then you get together and you're teaching them. Oh, y'all fellowship. Y'all teaching each other. I say that. Teaching each other. Either you up and you teaching. And then they're going to be warned to come and ask you this question. They already know the answer. But they don't see what you do. What do you know? They don't search the scripture backwards, front one, forward. They went the long way and came around with it. And they come up with the same answer.
Amen.
But they're going to see how they can deceive you and cause you up.
Oh,
but the word say this, and you be like, what?
Wow.
You have to be like God when God was on this earth. God spoke to them in parable.
That's right.
Because they knew the answer already. God had to speak to them in parable so they wouldn't understand what he was talking to, but they couldn't understand what he was talking about.
Because
they know the answer. And God, but when you talking to somebody like this in their face. And you know. Now you recognize that God would give us this, if he would give us this gift to get in front of a person and they talking to you. It discern what they saying before they say it. But you know there'll be a lot of messed up people, right? I mean a lot of messed up people. But God give people that gift, and God know how to right divide the word. They know how to do what the Spirit, how God put it in their heart. But you got some people is deceiving. Oh, you talking to me? I know what you finna say from what you gonna say to me.
Mm-hmm.
You lying to me. You finna tell me this. I'm gonna ask you a question. You know, God's asking, like he asked the disciple. He asked Aaron, do you love me?
Uh-huh.
He know who loved him. He know who didn't love him.
Right.
He already know what you don't know. That's love. That's love. That's truly 100% love. You acting somebody something, you know what they're going to say. You hear their thoughts. You hear their heart. What they finna say. A lot of people say they know you lying by your actions, by how you move, or how you to your face. I used to get set up like, why you get mad? I'm like about to accuse me. and don't be doing nothing but to get mad. He'd be like, man, I know I shouldn't have got mad, but I don't like nobody to tell me. I don't like nobody to accuse me. But who said that? You got to be a God was accused. He was accused of many things that he didn't do. But he still held out to the end. And he know he had to be prosecuted to go on the cross. Because what? He thirsts for. He thirsted for us. For our soul to be saved. Because he know that it wasn't a man on this earth. But he tried, put like this, he tried to see what somebody here. But then God had to come have a spiritual baby through Mary and put Jesus here to walk on the earth to show man you can do this. They think he went through 40 days fasting. So that you can go with the food for a long, long time. But being thirsty, you can't go for no long time without water. You can go without food. But without water, you got to have that water. You ain't got that water in your body, you will fall out, fall down. You'll be disobedient. You'll be just like you drunk, but you go because your intellect inside of you ain't right. But till you get that water, but mind you now, when you get that water, you can't take that water and just tap start. Go like this. Because you take it and you go fast with the water, you will hurt yourself. You can hurt yourself with it. This meaning the word. Ask God, give it into your heart, or you read the word, or you study the word, you got to take it piece by piece. And let it come in. Let it get deep, deep down. And when you say the well was deep, Jacob's well was deep. You got to let it get deep and rooted down. I mean, you got to go down and put this in there. Nobody can just make it just come up just like that. But when it's just deep, because you can keep storing the word inside you. And then when you need it to come out, it's wrecked. It's wrecked. And come, when it say spirit out of my mouth, that means he letting the word just come. He letting it flow. He letting the word flow. He's doing God's work. That means you're doing God's work and you know you're living right. Doing what God wants you to do. And in my closing, we're going to go to Matthew 22:37. Everyone got it? Jesus replied, "You must love the Lord your God with all your heart, all your soul, and all your mind." Then we'll go to the Old Testament, Deuteronomy 6:5. "And you must love the Lord your God with all your heart, all your soul, and all your strength." God telling us here with all our mind, also with all our strength, all the strength that's within us, that we love God fully and do God's will no matter what. Then we're saying of the thirst, it's a verse, the dictionary of thirst. Say, "I feel a heaviness, thirst. Grinding for, craving for liquid." And say, number two, say, "Edgy." Desire, edgy, long for yearning to be edgy minded, and you are impatient. Eager minded or impatient. That means you were saying that you thirsty for the water, you want somebody want to give you the water. But you want to take the water out of their hand. Say, "Give me here, I need it right now." Not knowing you won't take the water, you drink it, it's gonna hurt you. So you do like I say, you're taking it too fast, and you don't wanna take it fast. Then they say longing for something. You longing for it. It's like you can taste it before you get it. But we know water don't have no sufficient taste. In other words, you don't been a couple of places and drunk water. Knowing the difference. Yeah, you got a little taste, but no, it tastes like no soda or anything. You go to a river, you take the water, you start drinking the water like this. And the water nice, cold, running, smooth, going down good. And you don't feel no, you don't taste like some of the water here. You got a little dull taste in it, and tastes nasty. And you don't, "Oh, I don't like that." But if you ever been to a stream and drunk water from a running stream, the water tastes totally different, even up in the city somewhere, like in the country, it tastes totally different from here. But you got tap water here. But they said we thirst, that we are thirsty and water. I mean, thirsting for God. We're thirsting for Him, to long for Him and do His will. And loving Him, and we let God come into Him and say, "I thirst for You, longing for Your love." And I say, anyone thirst today, let them have it more abundantly, and God will give them. He will give you what you ask for. That's my closing. Amen. Thank God for the purification of the word. We speak the word and boldly. And what God gave me to say, that it helped someone, even if it hurt someone, that what God did for the word to do. Let it cut. Let it cut like a two-edged sword. And I thank God for this opportunity. It ain't me, it is God. I'm a vessel. He used me how He wanted to use me, not how I want to be. Because it was left up to me, I wouldn't even come up here.
That's it.
But God said, amen. It's time for you to do what you got to do.
Amen.
So here I stand as a servant of God. Moving forward.
Amen.
Moving forward in Him.
Amen.
Not being afraid. That prayer, evangelist prayers. When God give somebody to pray for you, He knows what's in you. He knows what's in you that's the fear. Even though she was praying, I feel the rising up within my soul. Because truly, even though you speak for a long time, you still feel that worriness. Because sometimes you be afraid of people, how people, what people don't not say. But people say things by expression on their face. I learned that. But learn how to ignore it.
Mm-hmm. But that's right.
Speaking to the people, I didn't Facebook land. Mm-hmm. Get off the Facebook line, tell people lies. Going, being living mischievous, curious, not living right, and you hiding behind a computer. Get off of it.
Yeah.
Live right for God.
Yeah.
Do what God wants you to do.
Amen.
If you're going to preach the word, preach it. But preach it with authority. Quit living lies. Do God's work. What He gave us here to do. Do. But stop criticizing people when they're speaking God's words. Do what God has for you to do in your heart. If you so desire not to serve God, let the devil keep using you and lead the people along and live. Them do what God wants them to do.
Amen.
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 Hallelujah. Glory to God. Come on, you can give God some praise. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Elder Lewis. How many feel your thirst ignited just that much more through the word of God? Amen. Father, we just thank you on this morning. We bless you, Lord God, for your very spirit that is amongst us, Lord God, for your glory, Lord God, for the Holy Ghost that is upon us and unctioning us, Lord God, to receive and partake of this word on today. We thank you, Lord God, that you are allowing, Lord God, us to thirst after you and you alone, Lord God. Ignite our thirst for you, Lord God, like never before in this time, Lord God, in these perilous times that we are living in, Lord God. We pray that you would ignite a thirst for you, Lord God, you alone. Ignite a thirst for your word. Ignite a thirst for intercession. Ignite a thirst for intimacy with you, Lord God, that we will seek the living water, hallelujah, that will cause us to never thirst again. We bless you on today, Lord God, for that well of living water, as your word says, bubbling up inside of us, glory to God, even to everlasting life. We bless you on today that all are coming unto you, Lord God. We stand in intercession for those who are in the position of the woman at the well of today and don't understand that this earthly water, this worldly water, these worldly ways, and I'm seeking relationship with men and through drugs and alcohol and sex and all these other things, partying and living in ways that are not pleasing to you, that we're seeking after to Lord God, to quench our thirst, oh God. We pray this morning, Father, that they would see you as she saw you, that they would begin to speak to you even as she spoke to you with an open heart to hear you, Lord God. And we pray today, Lord God, that all, Lord God, who are here speaking to you, Lord God, would hear you, Lord God, and that the thirst for God, the thirst for everlasting life, the thirst for the living water will be ignited, oh God, and that they would ask, oh God, today to give me of this water. I'm thirsting for you, God. We intercede now, Lord God, for all, Lord God, who are living in this way and don't understand, oh God, that there is a well of living water. Your word says you stood up in the assembly of the people and you called out to all who were thirsty to come to you and to drink, glory to God. Come without money and buy, glory to God. Drink of your fill, receive of me. We intercede, oh God, not only for the lost, but for the church today, Lord God, that we would come to you, Lord God, that we would return to the well, as the elder said, the well that is so deep, the stores of life, glory to God, that are in Jesus Christ alone. We pray that the church would run to this well, oh God, and that we, Lord God, would draw deeply, oh God, in the name of Jesus. We come and we press, Lord God, past every superficial way, oh God, in the name of Jesus, every shallow way, oh God. We pray that it be done away with in the name of Jesus, and not even named among the saints, but that we will press, Lord God, into the deep things of God and tap into this well of living water that comes to satisfy the thirst of our very souls, oh God. We bless you on today and we receive that water, hallelujah. Oh God, we receive the water of the Spirit on today, Lord God. We receive it, Lord God, hallelujah. Fill us, oh God, quench us this morning, oh God, that we won't be found, Lord God, in disobedience to you and choosing to quench your Spirit and instead to satisfy the lust of this old nasty flesh. We receive the water of the Spirit today, Lord God, hallelujah, that we can be quenched, oh God, that our thirst would be quenched in you and you alone, oh God. Oh Father, we just bless you on today, hallelujah. Thank you for your church coming, oh God. Come into the well of living water, oh God, and partaking that we in turn, oh God, can carry this water to a lost and a dying world, oh God. We thank you this morning and we pray, Lord God, your blessing over the man of God. We come against every backlash of the enemy now in the name of Jesus, oh God, and we pray, Lord, that you will strengthen him now, Lord God. Build him up, hallelujah, Jesus. We pray, Lord God, that your Spirit would rest upon him, oh God. Encourage him, Lord God, by your very Spirit, Lord God. Oh, hallelujah, to continue, Lord God, to run on, to continue, to grow in you, to continue in your word, oh God. We come against every way that is not like you in the name of Jesus. Oh, Father, we thank you for his willingness, Lord God, and we pray over the man of God, hallelujah. We pray over his very ministry, the ministry that is in his belly, Lord God. We know that he loves people, oh God, hallelujah, Jesus. Oh Father, we know that you've given a heart for your people, oh God, in the name of Jesus, and we thank you this morning, hallelujah, that it is by your Spirit, hallelujah, that you're using him, oh God. Father, we lift up our elder to you now, Lord God. Refresh him, allow the water of your Spirit, glory to God, hallelujah, God, allow the water of your Spirit to wash over him like never before. Refresh him now in the name of Jesus. We thank you that his footing is sure in you, Lord God. Hallelujah, God, that this is only the beginning. We pray that he is open to you, willing, Lord God, ready to be used of you, Lord God, each and every day. In the name of Jesus, we declare that every enemy of his soul is done away with now by the power of your Spirit. In the name of Jesus, and God, we just thank you today. Hallelujah, God. We bless you on today, Lord God, hallelujah, and we love you, hallelujah. We give you glory and we give you honor in Jesus' name, amen, amen. Hallelujah, hallelujah, Jesus, hallelujah, Jesus, hallelujah, God, hallelujah. Come, Elder, glory to God, hallelujah. Let's pray, glory to God. Hallelujah, Jesus. The members of the ministers of the house, glory to God. To encircle around our elder, glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Come on, all interceding, glory to God. For the man of God, hallelujah. Come on, just point your hand in this direction and begin to pray and intercede for the man of God, hallelujah. But surely the devil is mad on the day, glory to God. But he has stepped forth, glory to God. He has come forth, hallelujah, and done your will, glory to God, hallelujah. We you all today. Hallelujah, Jesus. Oh, hallelujah, God. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Every enemy of his soul is done away with now. In the name of Jesus, we thank you, Lord. Hallelujah, God. Oh, Father, we thank you for filling them like never before. Hallelujah, Jesus. Fill them now, oh, God. Hallelujah. Let the dreams of the Lord return unto him. In the name of Jesus, hallelujah. Let them operate in the prophetic, oh, God, in a mighty way. In the name of Jesus, begin to fill his belly, oh, God. Visions, oh, God. Open visions, oh, God. Hallelujah. Dreams, oh, God. Hallelujah. Interpretation of dream in the name of Jesus. We thank you, Lord God, as we pray, Lord God, over his very feet, Lord God. Order his footsteps, oh, God. We thank you that your word says the footsteps of the righteous are ordered by you, oh, God. Hallelujah. Order his very footsteps in the name of Jesus. Oh, Father, that he will walk in the ordained places of God. Hallelujah. And that he will take off, oh, God, ordained place in the name of Jesus. We speak to every demon and every devil right now in the name of Jesus. Even every ancient devil, every plaguing spirit, every tormenting spirit, every spirit of the past, oh God, we come against it now in the name of Jesus. We command it to be bound now in the name of Jesus. Bound with chains, oh God, bound by the anointing, God, in the name of Jesus. We thank you, hallelujah, God, that you are closing, oh God, his very ears to be anointed, oh God, to hear you like never before, oh God. And Lord God, we thank you for the boldness to speak accordingly, oh God. We thank you, Lord, for his faith rising up, oh God, to speak that which he hears in the name of Jesus. We do away with every spirit of intimidation, every lying spirit, every spirit of deception in the name of Jesus. We do away with it now, and we want it to be punished under the anointing of the Holy Ghost in the name of Jesus. You have anointed and appointed your vessel, oh God, to preach the word, hallelujah, to be your hands in the earth, oh God. We bless these hands in the name of Jesus. We bless these hands to be fruitful in the name of Jesus, fruitful in the work of the Lord, and fruitful in the natural work, oh God, to bless your people, to increase your kingdom in the name of Jesus. We thank you for much wealth in these hands, oh God, to be shed abroad, hallelujah, to meet the needs of many. We see your elders standing tall as an oak tree, oh God, one that is giving shade to many, hallelujah, one that is bearing much fruit, hallelujah, Jesus, causing many to come and eat and to be blessed in the name of Jesus. We thank you for spiritual fruit. We thank you for natural fruit. Glory to God. Natural substance in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. We thank you that your word says that you are always giving seed to the sower. And we thank you for the heart of a sower, Lord God. A heart to give, oh God. Not only a natural substance, oh God, but we pray that you will anoint his very lips, oh God. We pray that you would, just as you did the man of God, and Lord God, you touched his lips with a burning coal, oh God. We pray, Lord, that you would anoint his lips now, oh God, that there will always be the word of the Lord ready upon his lips, oh God, in the name of Jesus, wherever he may go, even when he's driving alone, oh God, give him the word of the Lord for someone else, oh God. Oh Father, we thank you for living water stirring up in his belly like never before in the name of Jesus. We call him blessed, hallelujah. We call him blessed, hallelujah. We call him blessed, hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Come on and give God praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, God. 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 Thank you, God. Hallelujah, Jesus. This is only the beginning, said God. Hallelujah, Jesus. This is only the beginning, said God. This is only the beginning, said God. Hallelujah. I said, as you talked about that well, when you look down in a well, you can't see nothing but darkness. But by faith, you let down that bucket and you draw. Glory to God. And it calls the very substance of life up up, hallelujah, right into your very hands, glory to God. God said, this is what I'm doing for you, glory to God. When you look for it, then you see nothing but darkness, and it looks like nothing is there. God says, by faith, glory to God, draw, hallelujah, and you'll cause the very substance of God to be made manifest right into your very hand, my. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God said, don't be deterred. God gave me a word about a week or so ago about holding on to the momentum of God. God said, don't stop now. If you stop, you'll become stagnant. God said, hold on to the momentum of God. Just as you step forth in the word on today, and as you devoted yourself to his study and getting into his word to prepare for today, God said, I want you to do that each and every day. Be ready every Sunday like it's your time. Glory to God. Hold on to the momentum of God. Be ye always ready. God said, there's never a waste in me. Time with me is never wasted. Time in me is like a paradigm shift, glory to God. God says he's doing a shift in you, glory to God, that when you spend 5 hours with me, it'll be like 5 minutes. You'll be able to get more done in your day when you spend 5 hours alone with me, glory to God. God said, hold on to that momentum. Don't shrink back. Don't go back. Don't even settle back. Glory to God. Don't sit down. Don't cross your legs. Don't get comfortable, said God. Hold on to the momentum of God. I see the wheel turning. Glory to God. Like Ezekiel looked up and saw the wheel spinning in the middle of the wheel. Glory to God. I see the wheel turning. Glory to God. I see the fire of God on that wheel. Glory to God. And I see it churning and turning. Glory to God. God say, catch hold, hallelujah, and hold to the momentum of God, and watch me catapult you, hallelujah. Glory to God. God say, yes, you're ready. He said, yes, you're ready. He said, yes, you. You mean me, God? Yes, you. God said, yes, you're ready. Yes, you're ready. Come on and tell him, I'm ready, God. I'm ready, God. I'm ready, God. I'm ready, God. Yeah. Hallelujah. God said, you will never be the same. You will never be the same again. He's doing a shifting. And it's a quick work that he's doing in you. My God. Matter of fact, it's already done. It's all just up to you. When you keep the pace, God say, I'm ready. My spirit is already running to and fro in the earth. It's up to you to keep the pace. Glory to God. It's already done. I've ran ahead of you and already marked it out, as a matter of fact. Glory to God. Hallelujah. That thing is already done and it's already marked out. Glory to God. I see a field, a track field. You know where they run on the track and the lines are marked out. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Every runner has his mark, has his place where he's going to start. Glory to God. God say, I don't want you looking to the left and looking to the right. It don't matter who else is in this race. Glory to God. This is about you keeping your eye on the mark. Keep your eye on the prize. Keep your eye on the finish line. Keep your eye on me, said God. You run your race and you stay in your lane. And I cause you to be victorious, glory to God, so you can receive that crown that the man of God talked about. Glory to God. God said it's within your reach. God said whatever you see, that's what you're going to hold in these hands. Glory to God. He's dealing with me so heavily about your hands. Oh my God. He said whatever you see, I didn't give you the vision for naught, said God. Whatever you see, this is the season for it to be made manifest in your hand. But it's all tied into your obedience to God. God said, I'm going to cause you to move in some strange ways. I'm going to cause you to speak as my mouthpiece. I anointed you with my word, and you must speak my word. Just like the man said, here am I, send me. As Jesus said, when God was looking for somebody to go into the world and seek out and save the lost, he said, here am I, send me, I'll go. This must be your heart, because God has already prepared so much for you. It's not by coincidence that he called you to be connected to the apostle of God. But church didn't come up with no child left behind. That's God. No man left behind, said God. He's called you two to walk side by side. And I see you walking with such a boldness, such an intensity, that fire that I give you, that fire that you allow self to use and become so angry about things of this world that you see concerning you. God say, I need you to turn that over and use that. Become on fire for the things of God. Let you with what these eyes see spiritually. What you see spiritually, let it vex your spirit and send you in an intersection. Calls you to use this mouth to speak. God said, don't worry about the words. I gave you the words. You speak. When God put it in your heart, you speak. It don't matter if nobody else don't understand what you say. When God put it in your heart, you speak. Say God. And be sure of what you're speaking. Speak with faith, say God. Speak with faith. Speak with faith. Speak with faith. Speak with faith, said God. I just see so much materializing in your hands, my God. It's like if you're holding your hands together like this. Just materializing because of your obedience to God. When you do this physically, you got to do it spiritually. Just like the words you preached. You got to be so thirsty for Him. It's like a dying man in the desert. His body can be so weary. He can be at his last. But if he see water on the horizon, oh my God. He'll press with everything in you. I don't care who's standing beside him or behind him calling his name. He's going to press with everything he has towards that water. God said, just as you stand and do this in the physical, you got to do that in the spirit. Hold out your bucket in the spirit and know that God is going to fill it. Glory to God. God is doing something great and mighty. I can't even see it all. I just know it's big. Amen. And this is the season. Amen. This is the time. This is the time of the miraculous. This is the time for God to do it. Amen. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Come on and give God praises. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Glory be to God.
I just want to give a quick testimony and encouragement to my dad. When he was earlier in the week, I wasn't going to dance this Sunday. And I was sitting at my computer studying, going back and forth because there's so many things that the Lord lay on my heart. That just, I mean, from one thing, I'm like, oh God. But I stopped for a moment in the song, this song, As the Deer, came into my spirit. And this is one of the songs where I'm hoarse and can't sing. I still, with my messed up voice, sang it. And the Lord put it in my heart to dance it. But I didn't know the song word for word. That was on Monday. Now Thursday, my dad was studying. And he came to me, he said, proofread this for me. So I showed him how to do what he was doing on his phone. And when I looked at the topic, you heard me, didn't you? I said, I felt a leap in my belly. I'm like, God, you did tell me to do what I didn't tell him what I was doing. But I encouraged him that. I just encouraged him, didn't I? I encouraged him to keep going. Whatever God, like she just said, do it. Don't second guess yourself. Don't second guess God. And he told me how he came up with the topic of the sermon. And I'm like, wow, that's powerful. And it's just so wonderful how on the same day,